You're crawling across scorching asphalt, each inch sapping what little energy you have left. You're on death's doorstep. After your second seizure today, your brain feels like it's crawling with fire ants, and your tongue is as dry as charcoal. Your body screams with pain, from your organs to your joints. Every move is agony. Oh, and you're pretty sure you just saw the devil in the corner of your eye laughing. And we're sorry to inform you, it's actually going to get a lot worse. On today's episode of the Infographic Show, what happens to your body when you don't drink water? Here's a little spoiler for you. Nothing good. This episode is best enjoyed with a bottle of water close at hand. So how'd we end up like this? Stranded in the desert, marooned on a boat at sea, surrounded by endless water with none to drink? Not even close. It started with you making a stupid bet with your buddy over 50 bucks. Which one of you could go the longest without drinking water? And you really need that 50. Imagine how many V-Bucks that'll buy. You powered through entire days without a sip during those intense lock-in gaming sessions. So how hard could this be, right? Even though the news is reporting an incoming heat wave, it's no big deal. You head into the mission brimming with confidence, munching on your ultimate snack. Saltine crackers slathered in salted butter topped with a slice of extra mature cheddar. Little did you know, the most agonizing and potentially final hours of your life were barreling toward you like a runaway train. So let's talk demographics. We've seen our YouTube analytics. It's safe to assume you're probably a male aged 14 to 30, of average weight, height, and build. We don't mean to profile you, but when it comes to the effects of dehydration, who you are matters. Time and severity can all be affected by age, health, activity levels, your physical properties like height and weight, and your sex. Will you be upset if we assume you're probably not an endurance-conditioned ultramarathon runner too? And no, marathon Netflix sessions do not count. To pass the first few hours of this ill-advised challenge, you dive into a binge of informative videos on your favorite channel, The Infographic Show. You're so absorbed by the entertaining educational content, you hardly notice the dull ache starting to pulse behind your eyes. How could this happen? You bought a pair of those blue light blocking glasses. Those are a scam, by the way, you just need to blink more. By the time you pause the videos to go take a pee break, you're already experiencing the early stages of dehydration. 60% of your body weight is fluid, and losing even 3% of that is a one-way ticket to Dehydration City. Of course, if you just admitted that risking your comfort and health for 50 bucks was a dumb bet and poured yourself a tall glass of water, you would be perfectly fine. Despite recommendations to drink X glasses of water per day for optimum health, most experts agree that just drinking when you're thirsty is the best way to be. But your mama didn't raise no quitter. If you won't sacrifice your health for a measly 50 bucks, can you even call yourself an American? Set that glass down now and keep shriveling. How could you know it's about to get worse? By the time this has been going on for 6 to 8 hours, you're feeling pretty crappy, your mouth is getting drier, and that's thanks to your body's increasing difficulty to produce saliva without the necessary fluids. This, by the way, is going to put stress on your entire digestive system. So the cheese and crackers are going to come back to haunt you later. Oh, and of course, that headache is getting a hell of a lot worse now. A few hours into one of our You Versus playlists and it's starting to feel like you versus your own brain. Fluid deprivation headaches can be agonizing and localized to the front or the back of your head, kinda making it feel like you lost a fight with an invisible power drill. One theory for dehydration headaches is that the fluid is shifting out of your brain and it puts stress on the meninges, the pain receptors in the brain's lining. And buddy, your meninges are feeling plenty stressed right now. But that's not the only reason you're feeling like a sack of human manure right now. The sense of this thirst is really tugging at you now. It's like your body is sending you an email marked URGENT after the lamina terminalis in your brain detects dehydration in your blood. Even if the rules don't forbid you from imbibing the liquid of life for your 50-buck bet, let's be honest, you're not exactly bursting with motivation right now. Your whole body feels heavy and sluggish. It's such a monumental effort to even make your way to the pantry for more of those delicious salty crackers. When you get up too quickly, you get a sudden head rush that makes you feel dizzy and nauseous. It's like you're drunk and hungover at the same time, with none of the fun parts. Do the horrible side effects of not drinking water really come at you this quickly? You don't even know the half of how bad it's gonna get. If you hadn't gone all in on this bet, you could still save yourself with ease. A few glasses of water, a bit of rest, and in a few hours, you'll be right as rain. But instead, you decide you're gonna skip the few glasses of water and go straight to bed. Maybe a good night's sleep is exactly what you need to speedrun this bet. Your friend doesn't stand a chance. And you may be right there, but it doesn't mean you'll do much better. When you wake up, it feels like you went on a 3-day drinking bender. This isn't an accident, given that a good portion of a hangover's nastiest effects are due to the alcohol-induced dehydration. As you get up, you notice that your arms and legs hurt to move. That's because of another crucial role that water plays in your life, lubricating your joints and spine. The more dehydrated you get, the worse you are gonna feel while moving. But that's not the only thing that's working against you. The air around you is thick and soupy, with that dense, uncomfortable heat, like when you open the oven too soon to check if your chicken nuggets are done. It's the heat wave that the news was warning you about, and your skin is covered in a thin film of sweat. You're losing more liquid than you're gaining. You're tired, you're thirsty, you're sweaty, your joints ache, your mouth is dry, and you've still got a killer headache. You need to throw in the towel and get some pep in your step. But instead of foregoing the $50 and getting yourself some cold, refreshing agua, you make the worst decision possible, putting on a pot of coffee. Coffee is wet, so it'll count as some cheeky under-the-table hydration, but only for regular coffee connoisseurs. Unfortunately for you, you're not a serious coffee drinker. The caffeine in coffee is a diuretic, meaning that it makes you pee more frequently and lose more and more of your precious fluids. And given that when you amble to the bathroom, your pee looks like liquefied SpongeBob, you don't have much room to maneuver here. That yellow color in your pee is a result of your kidneys processing hemoglobin byproducts as it filters the blood. If you were drinking like a normal person, the water passing through your system would dilute those biological chemicals. However, since you are deciding to torture yourself, the waste products are concentrated, resulting in a much darker, stinkier vintage of pee. And that's not even the only way it'll make your bathroom experiences more gross and miserable. Hydration is a crucial component of keeping your bowel movements regular. Remember when we told you all that cheese and crackers would come back to haunt you? Well, that's right, your increasing dehydration will make you constipated, which is a kind of hell all its own. Once again, you have an opportunity to save yourself here. If you chug a big bottle of water right now and kept sipping whenever the thirst hit for the rest of the day, this misery could fade into nothing more than an unpleasant memory. But you are the stubborn type and you really want that $50 no matter the cost. And believe us when we say there are far more horrific costs still to come. As the day goes on, your health starts to get worse and worse. You start to feel moody and unstable. Hydration is important for regulating the transfer of a number of hormones in your brain. The breath in your Sahara mouth has started to smell like a morgue with a broken AC. You don't have the fluids in your body filtering out all the nasty waste products. You're also starting to feel hot, really, really hot, and not just because of the heat wave outside. Hydration is an important part of temperature regulation, and without it, all of the dials are going up to 11 in the worst ways. You start feeling severe muscle cramps in the heat. Walking is starting to feel inconvenient. Your throat is chafing. Why does the air feel so thick in here? If only you had $50, you could buy a fan or an air conditioner. This couldn't possibly have anything to do with all the water you're not drinking. It's time to get out of the house. Maybe the air is fresher out there. There's a park where you live. You'll probably benefit from the exercise. Your heart is already pounding in your chest from the coffee. But things don't get any better at the park. All you see are the reminders of what you're missing. Joggers run past, drinking out of water bottles. People stopping and sipping out of the communal water fountains. Even the river running next to the park just makes you feel so helplessly thirsty. You think maybe you should just head back home, get some sleep. It hurts less when you're asleep. You're probably so close to getting that $50 prize, but your thoughts don't come easy. In fact, they're getting strange and incoherent. Under the hood, you're dealing with lowering blood pressure and cerebral edema, also known as swelling of the brain, which will lead to our next not-so-fun effect of dehydration. Is that the devil? Now maybe you're going mad, but you can see the devil in the background. He is laughing and dancing, hopping around in the park. This is the hallucination phase. You're starting to see things that are not really there as your mind breaks down from a lack of fluids. At this point, you are beyond having just a few bottles of water to help you. To bring you back from the brink, you probably need to go to the hospital and get an IV drip. But you're not going to do that, are you? You really want that 50, so you ignore the dancing devil and head back home. Maybe if you sleep again, you'll be okay in the morning. Your buddy will probably have given up on this contest by then, and that sweet, sweet prize money will be yours. You don't know it yet, but you might just be crossing the point of no return. When you wake up the next morning, you are an absolute wreck. You feel like death. You've got nausea and pain all over. You got no appetite for food. It's not like you've pooped in the last 2 days anyway. And you have this feeling that if you just have another coffee, you'll have a heart attack right there on the spot. But your heart isn't the only organ under attack right now. For starters, you're undergoing the onset of kidney failure. As your fluid levels plummeted, your brain prompted the release of an antidiuretic hormone, telling your kidneys to reabsorb and retain water. The kidneys filter the blood, and as acute dehydration sets in, blood pressure falls and the waste products in your kidneys build up. This in turn can lead to acute kidney injury. And in your case, it will. You're also dealing with shock liver, where low blood pressure cuts off blood flow to the liver, causing cell-killing necrosis. Safe to say, you are cruising down Bad Time Street. And the damage to your kidneys and liver can result in a sudden onset of lactic acidosis, which is every bit as nasty as it sounds. The damage of those crucial filtering organs stops your body from metabolizing lactic acid, causing a buildup that results in everything from breathing issues to jaundice. You just about manage to get yourself out of bed as your body fails, system by system. But as you stand, you suddenly feel like you're being given an electric shock. Your eyes roll back into your head and your muscles all start spasming. You're too out of it to realize this, but you just had a seizure. A nasty side effect when dehydration reaches dangerous levels. Maybe one more walk will solve this. You head outside. Ah, is that heat wave still going? You're not even sure if it is. It might be your utterly shot temperature regulation system. If only you started drinking water again the day before, you might have been able to save yourself. Soon enough, you collapse onto the asphalt of the street. It feels so hot underneath your face, you don't even have enough liquid or food in your system to puke. Your muscles give up on you, your organs fail, you're gripped by one more nightmarish dehydration seizure. And then on day three, you are done. But hey, if it makes you feel any better, your friend died too, so nobody's really a winner when you decide not to drink water. What's your driest story? Got an H2O ship to share with your hydro homies? Drop them in the comments below. Now go check out how long could you actually survive no sleep? Or dehydrate while watching this video instead.